in my sorrow. Some of Jesus' own words from Joshua. Then she wiped them with her hair, kissed them, and anointed them with the ointment. When the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he said to himself, "If this man were a prophet, he would know who and what sort of woman this is who is touching him, that she is a sinner." Jesus said to him in reply, "Simon, I have something to say to you." "Tell me, teacher," he said. "Two people were in debt to a certain creditor. One owed 500 days' wages, and the other owed 50. Since they were able to repay the debt, he forgave it for both. Which of them will love him more?" Simon said to the prophet, "One, I suppose, whose larger debt was forgiven." He said to him, "You have judged rightly." Then he turned to the woman and said to Simon, "Do you see this woman? When I entered your house, you did not give me water for my feet, but she has bathed them for tears. Wipe them with her hair. You do not give me a kiss, but she has not ceased kissing my feet since the time I entered. You did not anoint my head with oil, but she anointed my feet with ointment. So I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven. Hence, she has shown great love. But to the one who little is forgiven, loves them." He said to her, "Your sins are forgiven." The other disciples people said to themselves, "Who is this who even forgives sins?" But he said to the woman, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now, for the watch here, and I don't want to see your grandma things done on time. I'll open the chat for you. To come to my mind was the poem we just read. seen it, those who are great knew it was important. It's a beautiful insight into a heart of Jesus Christ. And whether we realize it on the face of it or not, it is a beautiful gospel of healing. Because even though we don't know your name, we don't know your story, we don't know what led her to expose herself like that, to put herself in that position of humility, at the very least, we can guess she was looking to be healed somehow. I think it's a good assumption. No one goes to those kind of lengths that I'm looking for some kind of peace or some kind of healing. And the beauty of it is that she gets it. Jesus heals her. Not a physical healing, maybe, but an even deeper one. Because when she stands up, she is reborn. She has come to new life. All because her hurts and her wounds and her scars, and she laid them at the feet of Jesus Christ. And she's healed. This kind of mission is our chance to do that same thing. Whatever our wounds, whatever our scars, whatever our hurts, whatever our baggage, whatever it might be, we have two opportunities, the nights that we are here, to lay them at the feet of Jesus. As he stands right before us in the Blessed Sacrament, and when we meet him face to face in the sacrament, we place ourselves at the feet of Jesus Christ. Not caring what anyone else thinks, not caring what the crowd thinks of us, just knowing that we can be back in the kingdom of Jesus Christ. Heal the wounds and your love. What's interesting though, and don't know where I'm from. Father, that's really good, but you don't know where I've been. You don't know the person I was. You don't know what I did. You don't know what I'm doing now. You don't know how I'm living now. How can Jesus forgive that? How can Jesus love you the way that you say he loves you? The way you love that person in the gospel. How?
What ways are we lying? In what ways?
God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against us, God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will then condemn? It is Christ Jesus who died, rather, who was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who intercedes for us. What will separate us then from the love of Jesus Christ? Will anguish or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or the sword? No, I say. In all these things we conquer overwhelmingly through him who has loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor present things, nor future things, nor powers, nor heights, nor depth, or any other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen?
Amen.
That is our faith. That is what we profess as disciples of Jesus Christ. Nothing, nothing, nothing can get in the way of Christ's love for us. In the middle.